I'm here today by Jennifer Doyle from Contracting Plus. Jennifer is a client solutions manager and will talk with me a little bit about the trends in contracting. Jennifer, so if you could let us know what's happening in the market at the moment.
Yeah, absolutely. Look, thanks very much for having me, Marcel. As Marcel mentioned, I am a client solutions manager with Contracting Plus. So just maybe to give you a bit of context, Contracting Plus, essentially we do two things. So we help new contractors. So anybody who's new to the contracting space, we would help them set up through umbrella companies. We look after all of the invoicing, all of the taxes. And then we also help contractors who want to set up their own limited company. And we give them some advice on how best to kind of manage their company. So just to kind of give you guys a bit of context about, I suppose, Contracting Plus, who we are and what it is that we do. In terms of contracting trends at the moment, I mean, obviously, we're in the middle of a current pandemic. So I think it'll be some time before a lot of companies will really know the impact that this has had. In saying that, I suppose anytime there is kind of an economic downturn, what we generally see is that permanent roles will go down and contract roles will spike up. So back, you know, in 2008, we had a huge spike in contingent workforce, gig workforce. I don't expect it to be quite the same, but I think at the moment contracting is very attractive to companies. You know, there's still that bit of uncertainty, but at the same time, there are projects that still need to get done, and hiring somebody who's a highly skilled individual on a project basis is obviously very attractive for companies at the moment. So we're seeing a lot more activity in the market over the last couple of weeks. I think we're expecting, you know, a busy September as well.
Yeah. No, I hope so too. It's going to be definitely beneficial for myself. And how did COVID affected you? Did you have, like, you know, those first months especially? Were they a big drop of contractors or?
You know, I think in terms of certain projects did get paused maybe or pushed, but thankfully, you know, overall, I think contractors, you know, did continue to work. And by the very nature of what they do, they operate as independent. You know, they're highly skilled individuals. They're working on a project basis. So remote working and flexibility is something that's often hand in hand with contracting. And, you know, I think this, you know, last couple of months has definitely changed a lot of perceptions for companies. They've kind of almost been forced into a full remote working situation. For a lot of companies, it's the first time. So I think people are enjoying the flexibility. They're enjoying the work-life balance. And contracting kind of naturally offers a lot of those. You know, those are some of the big benefits that contracting can give you, is that flexibility and how you work. You know, the opportunity to upskill, become a subject matter expert, work with lots of different companies on lots of different projects. So
perfect. The thing that I did notice when talking to people who want to go or hesitate going to contracting is that the mortgage part. So they are still very hesitant. So, like, I'm getting, you know, a few no's here and there when people say people want to go for the mortgage. So could you maybe share some light on that?
Absolutely. I think when it comes to mortgages for contractors, there's always been this kind of misconception. What I will say is contractors can and do get mortgages. We know that. Look, like everybody, there is certain things that you've got to have in place. The market at the moment is a little bit uncertain, but I think that's across the board. For contractors, you know, obviously there are certain things that you're going to want to do. You're going to want to make sure, you know, your finances are in order, that you have consistent savings, no different than an employee. The only kind of additional piece that usually the banks or the brokers will look for is sometimes the company information. So Contracting Plus, we actually prepare all of that for our contractors. So we can provide kind of a pack, essentially, any of the details that your bank or broker is looking for, we can provide. And sorry, the other thing that I would say is, you know, we sometimes would recommend, if you're unsure of where to start, talk to a broker who understands contracting. So if you're speaking to somebody who already understands the market, that can be a huge help. We have a couple of names. I'm happy to share them if anybody wants to get in touch. If that is something that somebody's looking for some support or guidance on, we can obviously share those names. But, you know, I think contractors, as I said, they can and they do get mortgages, and we're obviously here to help in any way that we can.
Perfect. And, like, if you could pick three biggest benefits of contracting, what would those be?
Yeah. Okay. Well, I think the first one is you get a higher rate of pay. So finances is obviously a top one for a lot of people. Essentially, you earn more money. So you're going to get paid well. And you also are able to really, with proper tax planning, so if you're working with a company like Contracting Plus, who are giving you advice on business expenses, on pension, on what are your long-term goals, how can we help you make the most out of that money, that's obviously key. I think gaining new experiences as well, you know, the marketplace is dynamic. People are working in different jobs, different careers, more and more. So there's a lot of flexibility. You can work with companies where maybe you haven't had the opportunity to work with them before, working with new teams, working with new softwares. And then that work-life balance, like that's a big one as well. So we would have, you know, whether that means, you know, for you, that means working from home, or whether that means taking the summer off. So we do have contractors who work with us who, you know, might work up to June. So they'll take contracts that finish in June. They'll have 2 or 3 months off over the summer period. They'll go back working again in September. If you can do it, lovely. Why not? absolutely. And if, again, if you're working with somebody like ourselves, you know, with a bit of clever tax planning, we can help you manage that income. So you might take a smaller salary from January to June to allow you to continue taking salary over the months that you're not necessarily working if you have a company. So the flexibility, you know, the experience, I think, building that strong CV, and then, you know, the financials are obviously a motivator for a lot of people as well. They'd probably be my top benefits.
Excellent, excellent. And can actually people coming from UK go for you as well?
Yeah, absolutely, absolutely. So what I'd say is, what I always feel is most important if you're taking a contract position in a new country or you're taking a contract position for the first time is get expert advice. You know, do talk to somebody early on. If you're moving, I suppose, at a really high level, because I won't go into all of the tax details in case we lose people, but I suppose at a really high level, what you need to consider is where you're physically undertaking the job. So if you're working in Ireland, you need to consider your Irish tax obligations. Okay. So either you can come to us and we can very easily get you set up in an Irish company and we can look after all of the invoicing and the taxes. Or if you have your own company, we can help you work through that in Ireland. So we need to look at the company. We need to take a look at you. But absolutely, look, it can be done. You know, there are lots of people who are looking at Ireland. I think at the moment I'm having a lot of conversations around things like relocating to Ireland, getting a PPS number. We actually have some really good information on the website. So contractingplus.com, there's an area called the Contractors Hub. So if you click into there, we would have a piece on relocating. We have a piece on using a UK company in Ireland. We have a piece on PPS numbers. So that might be a helpful place to kind of start researching as well, and pick up the phone and give us a call.
Great, great, great. So where can people reach you? You've got some contact details that you could share with them?
Absolutely, absolutely. Yeah. So the best number to call would be our Dublin number. So it's 01611-0707. And you'll get through to myself or one of the team. Or we also, again, if it's easier, I think the website, so contractingplus.com, we have schedule a call back. You can go onto the website and pick a time that's maybe more convenient for you, and we can pick up the phone and give you a call as well.
Excellent, excellent. Look, Jennifer, it was a real, real pleasure as always to have a chat with you.
No problem. Thanks for having me.
Hopefully we abolished the myth of the mortgage. I hope so, you know.
Absolutely. Well, as I say, look, come and talk to us. You know, I can share the names of mortgage brokers who understand the market if that's useful for anybody. And you know, any other kind of misconceptions or uncertainties, you know, pick up the phone, give us a call, and we can talk you through them.
Great, great. Perfect. Look, it was lovely to have you here, and have a great rest of the day, yeah?
Thanks, Marcel. Lovely speaking to you. Talk to you soon. Bye. Bye-bye. Bye.